final part of our afternoon on access to space. And this is a round table with four participants. Monsieur Tom Walkinshaw, who is the founder and CEO of Alba Orbital, which is a UK based in Glasgow company developing a small platform. We shall have also Jörn Spurmann, which is the chief commercial officer of Rocket Factory in Augsburg, developing launch services. We shall have also Monsieur Shufan Wu from China, from Shanghai, even to be more precise. By the way, I would like to recall that Shufan was with us last year here in Luxembourg, could not come this year, and he was a colleague at ESA when I was Director General of ESA. And we shall have on stage, because he's here in person, Monsieur Florent who is Vice President Sales of Arianespace. So as you can see, we have representative from Europe, representative from China, and I shall organize the round table the following way. I shall give each of you 4 to 5 minutes to say to the audience what is your company, which are the objectives of your company. And so that will be 4 times 4 to 5 minutes. And then I shall ask each of you the same question, because I think that we have no time for a debate, but I shall ask you, and I tell you the question that I shall ask you in advance for you to think. I shall ask each of you, which are your dream in the next 5 years? Because I think that we have also to dream. This is the best way to design the future together. So I'll give the floor to Tom Walkinshaw for, again, 4 to 5 minutes. So Tom, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Jean-Jacques, and it's an honor to meet you virtually, and you know, it's great to meet all the panelists as well. So I'm Tom Walkinshaw. I'm the founder and CEO of Alba Orbital Limited. We are a Pico satellite company. We specialize in pocket cube spacecraft. So these are very small satellites on the order of 5 centimeter cubes. And we deploy them in orbit. So we have satellite deployers, like so, and have spacecraft inside, and these deploy out the front. And we launched 2 of these deployers last year on a Electron launch vehicle, a Rocket Lab launch vehicle. And we also specialize in platforms. So we make a satellite called Unicorn 2. So this is a Unicorn 2 model, and it's a very compact, very advanced spacecraft, which is under 1 kilogram. So we're sort of recognized as sort of the world leading company in the very, very small stuff. Obviously Moore's law is enabling more capability in a smaller form factor, but that in itself isn't enough to ensure low-cost access to space. So Alba really works on taking out a lot of the friction. So we have ground stations called Alba Connect, and we have that deployed in Germany. And we build spacecraft, and we do payloads, and really the full ecosystem of space hardware. We have 10 spacecraft going up in December on a SpaceX Falcon 9 from Cape Canaveral. And we're really excited about that. So we're all really busy finalizing that just now and getting the spacecraft integrated. And yeah, we're an SME in Europe. We're growing pretty quickly. And yeah, we're doing a lot of cool things in space. So that's essentially Alba Orbital. And excited to take part in the Space Forum. It seems like a really exciting event. And great to meet everyone else.
Okay, so thank you. Thank you, Tom. Anyway, we shall come back later to you. And now I would like to give the floor to Jörn from Rocket Factory in Augsburg. I assume that you will not be able to show your launcher the same way we have seen the satellites. But the floor
Thank
is
you
yours.
Very much, Jean-Jacques. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for the invitation to speak. Yes, it's quite a match to Alba Orbital. So what Rocket Factory is doing, we're developing a small satellite launch service. So we have a two-stage vehicle and an orbital stage on top. And that orbital stage is perfectly suited to deliver small satellites to this place where they want to be. So it's capable of doing single plane phasing on orbit to deploy constellation in the quickest manner possible. It's capable to do run and inclination changes, so tiny, but it's possible. And by that, we can really be the perfect use case of a small constellation or small satellite deployment service. And the customer can really focus on entering into operations really, really fast. What our overall vision behind that overall approach is, we focus from day one. So our company exists since a bit more than 2 years. We ramped up in that time frame from C3 to nowadays 75 employees, so quite steep. And the vision that drove us is actually being based in southern Germany, that we can come to manufacturing rockets like we do with cars. So there's a huge industrialization chain in southern Bavaria with lots of industrialization capabilities and industrial components out of automotive industry. And we can spin in a lot of these. A lot of these components are actually good enough and sufficient to be used for space applications and launch applications. And that's what's driving us from day one, trying to find components and equipment that can we use on the different elements of the launch server, being it the launcher system or the launch site, and cutting costs tremendously to achieve very, very highly competitive launch prices. We have a really great team around that. So we have the internal team here at Rocket Factory. A lot of people have done this before. They worked in comparable endeavors on other micro launchers, which are already operational on orbit. So we have a clear second mover advantage with that. And also on the industrial landscape, we have strategic partners like OHD as an anchor customer, as MT Aerospace, who have all the infrastructure for the industrialization later on available. And we just need to go there and use the infrastructure to industrialize, which is truly magnificent. And with OHB, they already committed as an anchor customer to 5 launches a year. So our business idea finds really good market acceptance with OHB, but also with others. We have agreements signed with some brokers. We have lots of LOIs with customers, several hundred million euros in a sales pipeline. So it's really also, it's not only us seeing the greatness of our launch service, but also the customers, which is a good indicator for us that we are on good track. So much for RFA. Any questions that there might be later on, I'm happy to answer. Last fact to mention, our plan to be on orbit is for mid to end of 2022.
Okay, thank you very much, Jörn. Now I pass the floor to Shufan Wu. So Shufan, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Dordain, and first, thank you to invite me to be here, and I'm here sitting in Shanghai in the late evening now. So, I just introduced myself. I have a kind of three roles and three stages. First one is I'm a professional in the Shanghai Jiao Tong University. I'm the chair professor and also the executive dean of the School of Aeronautics and Astronautics. So Shanghai Jiao Tong University is a very well reputed university in China and in the worldwide. It's also very well known. And in my school is working mainly on the space technology and also on aircraft technologies. So my team is building some CubeSat. So we have an ongoing upscale project, which we build one CubeSat 3U, together with the Turkey team and with the Beihang team, we will build three satellites to be launched in mid of next year. And I think Shanghai Jiao University is a very open platform for any educational, scientific research, and joint space science, and all this kind of cooperation, international cooperation, we are more than welcome. So we are trying to keep to have a cooperation with European partners to go to Moon, so because China is now for the next stage of Moon exploration. They are calling for idea to go there together with international partners. So we also have a joint program, joint PhD program with many universities in Europe and in North America. So I think if there's any interest to have cooperation in either education or scientific research in space science and technology, so you are welcome to reach me. This is the first one. My second role is I'm a founder and also the board chairman of the Chinese commercial satellite company, which is called Beijing Minos Space Technology. It was founded in 2017. Now we have about 70 people. Over the past 3 years, we have built and launched 7 satellites into orbit. And some of them are at 10 kilo level, and we also have some microsatellite at the 70 kilo level, and reaching to Earth observation of below 1 meter or 1 meter resolution. So the company is a purely commercial satellite company, which mainly to provide solution to design and to build and to test and to help launch micro, nano, and now small satellites. So we have a plan actually now to build a 200 kilogram satellite with 0.5 meter resolution. And we also have an ongoing project to build a mini sub with a small satellite about 370 kilogram, and which will be launched in next year. So this is a pure commercial satellite manufacturing company. It's open to all potential customers in the worldwide. So that's the second role. My third one I want to briefly introduce is I'm also a co-founder of a small launcher company in China called Landspace Corporate. So which is on the top team in China for the commercial launcher business. So it was founded in 2015. So over the past 5 years, this company is going well now, have people about 300 staff, and have opened also several manufacturing factories in South China, in Zhejiang province. And the next big event is in mid of next year, or about 10 months, the first liquid launcher will have its maiden flight with about 5-ton capacity into Leo, and which will open the new stage for the company to be able to send satellite into orbit. So yeah, that's briefly. I was the co-founder. I helped to founded it. Although currently I'm not directly involved, but I'm still the shareholder, and also I was a board member of this company, and we have a direct access to it. So if anybody or any potential customer needs some business with Landspace, so you are welcome to contact me. Thank you. That's it.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Shufan. And again, we shall come back to you. Now, I would like to give the floor to Florent from Arianespace. So tell us about what Arianespace is doing these days.
Okay, thank you, Jean-Jacques. So first, I would like to say that we are always very pleased to be at this space forum where we have a lot of startups. It's clear that Arianespace is not what we can call a startup. We have been in the market for, in fact, this year we will celebrate the 40 years anniversary of the company. So it's not really a startup, but during those 40 years, we have been able to adapt ourselves, to listen to the market, to see what the market was expecting, and of course to be here and to have the opportunity to meet and discuss with different startups. It's very important for us to see what are the trends and to understand what could be the future, and we are certain that those startups are paving the way for the future. So it's important to be sure that we can answer their needs. So always very important. Arianespace, in fact, we are a company promoting and selling the European Space Agency launch vehicle, which are today Soyuz, Vega, and Ariane 5. Of course, we are involved in future programs and with European partners. We are working on future engines, LOX Methane, Prometheus. We are working as well on a program called TEMIS, which is a launcher that could be, or it's a demonstrator for having the capacity of a reusable launch vehicle. So we think, I mean, on the future, and we listen to what the market is telling us. But closer to us, we will have next year two new launch vehicle, or new version of our launch vehicle, that will fly for the first time. So first is the Vega C. It's a Vega with a bit more capacity, with a capacity of about 2 tons to 700 kilometers. And we will have the Ariane 6, mainly for a GTO mission to replace the Ariane 5. So what I would like to say today, and I would like, we have been launching this year six missions, and I would like to come back on the last one, which was Vega. We had a launch called SSMS for, it was a rideshare mission. We have launched 53 satellites for many startups, for company like university or company having already launched, but well, it was very important for us. It was the first rideshare. We have been able to demonstrate that the structure, the SSMS, has been working perfectly with different system tables, rings, to adapt any kind of small sat going from CubeSat. So it has been a success. We have learned a lot. We will issue soon a user manual to help the newcomer to understand how we work and to try to standardize as much as possible this kind of mission to be able to welcome people even at the very last moment. So it was a big success for us, very important. We believe that we could have a kind of mission, a rideshare mission every year, not easy, but we believe that it's feasible. We will maybe offer some different orbits, maybe equatorial. We will see what the market will request. So it's something that we would like to offer. And of course, one advantage of the SSMS is that we can use the structure for a piggyback mission, which means that when we have a main passenger, we can add a ring or a plate to put some small satellite on board as well, which will offer much more opportunity to the market. By the way, we have two missions beginning of next year where we still have some room, so anybody interested could, of course, contact us. And to further extend the opportunities and to fly, we will have on Ariane 6 what we call the MLS. It's a multi-launch system, which is a structure that will be able as well to welcome small satellites, which will be added on the main mission as well, on a piggyback. Or we are trying as well to settle a moon mission where we could have different players. For the time being, we don't have enough firm project, but we believe and we are discussing and we think that in the coming months maybe we will be able to structure that that mission. So for me, once again, it's very important to be here to understand what are the needs of the startups present to this event and to be sure that in the future we'll be able to welcome them in co. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Florent. So, at this point, I can say that you have a common goal, which is to decrease the cost of access to space. I think that Tom, Jörn, Shufan, and Florent, your goal is to decrease the cost of access to space. And I must say that that fits with what I said at the start of this session, is that this is contributing to the democratization of space, making space accessible for all on planet Earth. So I think that you have a very important role. Now, at this point, I shall give you back the floor. I think that we cannot organize an exchange among you. I think that it will be too difficult. So, as I told you at start, I am giving you back the floor one by one with one question that I would like to get from you, is that what is your dream? I am not saying your dreams, only one. Only one dream for the next 5 years. And I shall manage to make it true. So don't make your dreams, each of you. So, I shall see how I can help you, all of you. So, Tom, what is your dream for the next 5 years?
That's a good question. What is my dreams for the next 5 years? It's hard to say. I mean, I think I've been very lucky so far, and Alba's been very lucky so far to get as far as we have. And I think this year with the Falcon 9 launch, that's going to be a huge dream come true for us and for our community of POCU builders. That's really huge. In the five-year time frame, we want to be going really regularly. We want to be going in a big way. You know, I'd love there to be, you know, thousands of POCUs in orbit, and really coming, you know, the vision of democratizing space is a real thing, not just a kind of abstract concept. When people can, you know, come up with new ideas and create new businesses in space without all the crap that goes into it, all the headaches and the regulation and all the R&D, when people can deploy stuff in orbit quickly and easily, that's really going to be super important. But for me, I think really turning our kind of technology from a kind of cool little niche thing that's, you know, a tech demo into a real kind of commercial data business, I think it's really going to be huge. If people think they can make money going to space, there's going to be a lot more space, and there needs to be underlying infrastructure there to make that happen, and that's kind of what Alba is building for people, is that sort of gateway to space. And we'll have 16 spacecraft in orbit by the end of the year. Most of those people otherwise wouldn't have flown their spacecraft had Alba not existed, and for me that's really exciting. So hopefully in the next 5 years we'll have a lot more POCUBs in orbit, and constellations of POCUBs. That'd be really awesome. And just lots more satellites. I think we're all probably space guys here. I think it's probably safe to say that we're all sort of rooting for space. And I think anybody who likes space wants to do more of it and more regularly. And Alba's no different. We're all about, you know, flying stuff and really trying to, you know, 5 years time, hopefully we have thousands of satellites in orbit. That'd be the dream.
Okay, thank you. Now, Jörn, what is your dream?
Mm-hmm. My dream for in 5 years, I hope that by then we are significantly advanced in the commercialization of space transportation in Europe, that we have made a good leap there. Means for us, obviously, being on orbit in 5 years at full operational cadence of 20 launches a year, and that we can help you in fulfilling your idea, what you said, making space infrastructure and database services from this space-based infrastructure cheap. And that's the main goal that we need for future evolution of the, let's say, goals which come next in terms of exploration, human spaceflight, exploring the universe, and. And this is where I hope that we make significant progress. Means for me that hopefully everyone attending to the Space Forum will be a customer of Rocket Factory, including Tom. and that we see a very good ecosystem that is strongly evolving there on a commercial basis.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So, Shufan, what is your dream?
Well, maybe, yeah, it's a good question.
Since you have three jobs, which job you are taking for your dream?
Okay, I think as for the five-year dream, and if I call back Chinese commercial space, so it's right started 5 years ago. I mean, in China, we call 2015 as the starting T0 for Chinese commercial space, because that year, Chinese government opened the door for private investment into the space sector. So over the past 5 years, a lot of commercial private owned companies in all the chain of the space, launcher, satellite, ground station, data application, and so on, are really emerging. So it's still in the phase of growing. If we can say in next 5 years, I believe the Chinese commercial space sector will still grow up and eventually will come up with some winners and some losers. I think that's the rule. If we call for the three dreams, or the dream as a three rule, first rule, I would like to be able to play important role in the Chinese space science exploration program. For example, I mentioned China is going to Chang'e 7 in 2023-24, and we are trying to play some role on the university side to contribute to moon lunar exploration, and I hope we can get something there. That's first. And for the two commercial companies, satellite and the launcher, I'm sure in next 5 years, both of them will grow up greatly. And I can see the land space will certainly be able to run their liquid rocket, the first Chinese commercial liquid launcher. And especially in such a phase that China is building is a starnet or the LEO communication internet satellite, and they call a lot of launcher capabilities. I think they can play a big role. And for the satellite company, I think they will enter into many professional sectors for the satellite like SAR or like communication and Earth observation. I believe in the next 5 years, many things will be boomed, will be developed quickly and greatly, and many things can be realized and implemented.
Okay.
That's it. I look forward.
Thank you very much. So, Florent, what is your dream?
So I will be short, but if I have one personal dream, I think it would be to see Thomas Pesquet taking off from our launch port in French Guiana. Definitely, we see that many countries are having that goal, and we know that we will need to do so one day or the other, and of course, the sooner the better.
Okay, so thank you very much. Not sure that I can help you to make your dreams come true, but okay, I shall try to help you. What my dream is to have you all four in Luxembourg next year to give where you are with your respective dream. So rendezvous next year in Luxembourg, and take care. Thank you very much.
Sounds good. Thanks. Bye.